Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Liftoff. NASA, one of the greatest space companies in the world, has been keeping an eye on some of the most interesting aspects of space. This includes all of the planets and their satellites, whether natural or artificial. With this, NASA has been keeping a close eye on our moon, where they hope to land again soon. But as they were watching the moon, they discovered something quite interesting. They discovered that there was a rocket crash on the moon, and they claim it was not from Earth. How could this be? The surface of the moon is not as clean as you would think. There are hundreds of pieces of debris that can be found on the surface of the moon. Among this debris are lunar landers and even astronauts' fecal matters in Ziploc bags. In addition to all of that, the surface is not smooth. There are a lot of craters on the surface, each one caused by various items. The most notable ones are the craters that measure about 40 yards wide on the surface, which were caused by the rocket boosters from the Apollo mission. In 2019, Israel's Bereshit spacecraft crashed on the surface, scattering debris all over the lunar surface. According to data collected in 2016 by Arizona State University, there are more than 47 rocket bodies that have created some sort of spacecraft impact on the surface of the moon. However, most recently, NASA made a discovery that was quite shocking. The astronomers at NASA discovered that there was a recent impact on the lunar surface that curiously created two craters on the dark side of the moon. But how could that be? What is it that could have caused such a great impact that could have caused a double crater? To find out what caused the double crater, make sure you watch this video till the end. Rumor has it that it's something not from this Earth. But before we find out what it is, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe to get nothing but the latest news on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, technology, and so much more. So, what could have caused the double crater? Even though the mysterious rocket crash became known to the public a few weeks ago, the rocket part that crashed on the moon was spotted on March 4th. Because of this crash, there is now an eastern crater on the moon that is about 18 meters in diameter, which is about 19.5 yards. This crater is superimposed on a western crater that measures 16 meters in diameter, which is roughly 17.5 yards. According to NASA, the double crater may indicate that the rocket body had some pretty large masses at each end, and they were large enough to cause the double crater. But the thing is, even though the Apollo SIV-B craters were larger, there are no other rocket crashes on the moon that have created double craters. NASA, along with other astronomers, has not yet been able to confirm which nation or company's rocket crashed on the lunar surface. Not only that, but no one has claimed responsibility for owning the rocket. In a NASA press release, Mark Robinson, a professor in the School of Earth and Space Exploration at Arizona State University, said, "Typically, a spent rocket has a mass concentrated at the motor end. The rest of the rocket stage mainly consists of an empty fuel tank." Since the origin of the rocket body remains uncertain, the double nature of the crater may indicate its identity. Robinson also happens to be the principal investigator for the NASA Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter Camera and a new NASA lunar imaging experiment called ShadowCam. According to a report by the New York Times, it was first speculated in January that the rocket was part of a second stage of a SpaceX Falcon 9 that was launched in 2015 on behalf of the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration for its Discover Deep Space Climate Observatory project. However, those claims were later ruled out. Bill Gray, the developer behind the Project Pluto astronomical software, was the one who spotted the rocket first in January. Since then, he had been tracking it as it approached the moon. He found that the vast hunk of metal was moving at a speed of about 3.3 miles per second before it finally crashed onto the lunar surface on March 4th. And when it crashed, he discovered that it was no ordinary crash. The software that was created by Bill Gray tracks objects in space. As he was tracking the mysterious rocket, he had to work backward and compute an approximate orbit. This was mainly because, as much as China will announce and televise their launches, they almost never reveal their routes. According to Ars Technica, Gray had put forward an argument in January that this rocket was part of the second stage of the Falcon 9 rocket. However, upon closer investigation, a NASA engineer said that the launch trajectory did not fit with the orbit of the rocket. This made them rule out the rocket. Later on, Gray concluded that the likely candidate was a Long March 3C rocket that was launched from China in 2014. But then again, this could not be the case, because China's Ministry of Foreign Affairs gave a statement on February 21st regarding this. It was reported that the upper stage of the rocket related to the Chang'e 5 mission entered into Earth's atmosphere and completely burned up. However, this assessment by China did not satisfy Gray, and he strongly disagreed with it. He argued that when China was performing their assessment, they got two different but similarly named lunar missions mixed up. In spite of all that, Gray made an argument that there should be some official agency, such as the US Space Force, or maybe even international agency, that should be tracking space junk in faraway space, not just objects such as asteroids in a lower orbit. In his Project Pluto blog, Gray wrote, "Many more spacecraft are now going into high orbit, and some of them will be taking crews to the moon. Such junk will no longer be merely an annoyance to a small group of astronomers." Having ruled out the Chinese rocket also, it now remains a mystery as to what could have caused the double crater formation. NASA is doing all they can to identify what could have caused the double crater, but so far, there's been no progress whatsoever. But now that raises a question. Will NASA proceed with its plans to fly around the moon? For some time now, NASA has been planning on how it will land a crew back on the lunar surface. This will be more than 50 years after some US astronauts walked on the lunar surface during the Apollo program. The new mission by NASA is known as Artemis, which is the Greek word for Apollo's twin sister in Greek mythology. NASA is planning to kick off the Artemis era later this year with the very first launch of its mega rocket, which they're calling the Space Launch System, or SLS. This mission, which is dubbed Artemis 1, will make its flight around the moon and back with no crew aboard. This mission is expected to last for about 26 to 42 days, depending on how successful it will be. With this, NASA is hoping to achieve its next giant goal, which is to land some astronauts at the South Pole of the moon. They're working to make this happen by the end of 2025. To boost the Artemis program and make sure that it's successful, NASA has contracted some space companies to send a series of robotic landers to the moon. These landers will be carrying some NASA-funded instruments that will explore the surface as they enhance the science that could come from astronaut missions. However, as much as NASA is progressing with the mission, it still faces some major challenges. The main one is whether the US Congress will agree to pay the cost of several billion dollars per flight. But if Congress were to agree and NASA were to proceed with what they have envisioned, it would be a major boost to science education and public awareness in general. It'll be just like the Apollo program, which was born out of the Cold War-era space race between the United States and the Soviet Union, and it ended up inspiring a generation of scientists and engineers. We just hope that with the most recent discovery of the mysterious crash on the lunar surface, the Artemis program will not be delayed and all will go as scheduled. What do you think could have caused such a huge crash to leave a double crater on the moon? Feel free to let us know in the comment section below. Also, make sure you smash the like button, and if you're a fan of all things Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, technology, and so much more, make sure you also smash that subscribe button for the latest news. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.